This is group one, and this is our entrepreneur and ethics project. Our company is called Elephant Squad, and our product is the Everyday Office Carry Phone Case, or Office Express Phone Case. This product is a phone case that carries office supplies such as sticky notes, a tab dispenser, built-in stapler, paper clips, mini-size highlighters, and writing utensils. However, our main feature is that you're able to charge it through solar power. The case contains the main essentials a person who is on the go needs for school, work, or any important task that may require the use of office supplies. Our company revolves around being environmentally friendly, having fair labor conditions, excellent customer service, and producing quality products at an affordable price. Our idea came from, you know, our experiences as students when taking notes, dealing with multiple documents, and just trying to stay organized. Some key questions for our company that led us to just think about our direction is, what type of impact will we have on society? What makes our company confident of this product? And what is the biggest risk for this company and the product? Now you get to meet the team. This is Tavri C. Kun. She is the project lead for Elephant Squad. She is currently attending California State University East Bay and pursuing a major in business administration with a concentration in information technology management. She is recognized for her leadership skills, teamwork, and as a student who is balancing her education and duties to her community, she understands firsthand the benefits of analyzing the finer details of any venture. Next, we have Tiffany Liu, who is also a student at California State University East Bay, majoring in computer science. Her motto is the three selves: self-motivated, self-starter, and self-conscious. She is always striving for the best and has extensive background in logistics and in leadership. We have Yu Hsin Yen, who is an international student. She is attending California State University East Bay and majoring in business with a concentration in accounting. She has great communication skill and also a show of great adaptability. She can multitask the responsibilities of an athlete and a student. With her dedication and work ethic, she feels confident in her abilities. Lastly, we have Zhang Qiyu. She is originally from China. This is her first semester at California State University East Bay, and she is also majoring in computer science. She has work experience at the farmers market, handling customer complaints, scheduling shifts, and also training new staff members. Now going deeper into our business proposal, the Elephant Squad goals are to ensure quality products are created using eco-friendly resources, increase profits by 10% annually, and reduce carbon emissions. Our mission is to provide a high-quality and eco-friendly product to our clients and consumers. For our values, we will respect the environment, meet consumers' expectation and changing needs, and ensure high customer service standards. Our purpose is to bring innovation and provide convenience to those on the go. For our compelling value, Elephant Squad will pay attention to details and be responsive to consumer feedback. This, you know, our product acknowledges that a phone has many applications to make our lives easier, but a multifunctional phone case allows people to have more convenience. This is accomplished physically with the tools the phone case will carry and the special feature of charging the phone through solar power. There's a function to stop charging the phone once a full charge is reached to ensure neither the phone nor the product are damaged from overheating. For the market value, there are multiple multifunctional phone cases, But however, for our competitors, they don't really mention or go into detail whether their phone cases are eco-friendly, which makes our product self-sustaining. Not only is our product made with environment-friendly materials, which we do plan to outsource if necessary to ensure quality standards are met, also, Elfin Squad will be public on where we outsource our resources and our manufacturing process while keeping key methods on forming the final product confidential. Our company plans to offer vending machines on college campuses or high traffic office spaces. This allows the consumer to buy directly without any hassle. However, we are open to selling our product through retail such as Walmart, Target, or Costco, and e-commerce with our own website that may offer more variations of our product. A case study that we have looked into is for OtterBox. What our company has learned from OtterBox in terms of maximizing our startup's potential was to create a product that not only offers different versions for different devices, but one that has an increasing demand. In addition, the company should continue to follow technological trends on how to innovate the product and network with mobile companies to be aware of new releases. The founder, Kurt Richardson, specifies that OtterBox is prepared for changes due to a rapidly changing consumer market, which he requires each department in his company to submit a new plan every 6 to 8 weeks to take note on current trends and resources. This taught our company, Elfin Squad, to be observant of consumer demands in order to innovate our product to meet their expectations. Here are some key milestones and checkpoints for our company. We have the initial state, which we will establish both technical and business requirements for our company and product. Second is the design phase, which we will design the product by creating multiple blueprints and 3D models. This will also help us check for any design issues. Following that is the product development, which will create and test a prototype of the product. If flaws are found or changes need to be made, we will return to the design phase to redesign the product. Next is implementation, which we will produce and launch the product. During this time, we will record sales and demographic of consumers. And lastly, we have the operation state, which we will continue producing the product and restocking inventory. Now for our objectives and key results. For objective one, we have increased profitability by 2.5% every quarter, and the key results for this objective is to achieve monthly revenue growing at 15% every quarter and the number of customers increased by 30% every quarter. For our second objective, it is to create a high-performing manufacturing and design team by quarter four of year two. The key results are to hire 5 new employees with backgrounds in design and research by the end of quarter two of year two. Another is to hire 10 new manufacturing employees by the end of year one. And then we will document individual contributions for performance measurement metrics and improve their skills by training. For the third objective, we have to increase the efficiency of multiple processes by quarter three for year four. The key results is to introduce new tools such as manufacturing machines and techniques such as product design methods by quarter one of year three. We will then oversee training sessions of new tools and techniques by quarter three for year three. And then overall productivity increased by 35%. For objective four, we will upgrade the product and develop it to compete with competitors' products by quarter three of year five. The key results, we plan to identify 20 leading competitors within the same market. We will also research common features and how to improve the market, and then replicate high quality features and add-ons. And lastly, for objective 5, we will improve customer service and support experience by end of year 5. The key results, which are, you know, resolving urgent issues within 1 hour of submission of the complaint, and for normal complaints, are resolved within 24 hours. For customer feedback rating scores, we plan to exceed 80% primarily. And then for the customer service team, they will have bi-monthly audits, which we will then review and further train them. How does Elephant Squad define success? We define success by completing the set objectives in our OKRs and reevaluating our company's performance and direction in order to create new objectives. By setting concurrent objectives being met in a 5-year time frame, this allows the company to adapt to change and innovate our product. How will we differentiate from others? Our product includes features in a combination that are rarely incorporated in other multifunctional phone cases. A main feature of the phone case is being able to charge the device by solar power, and the phone case has a safety function to turn off when the device is fully charged, and the consumer can turn off charging manually by a switch. Another unique feature is the corner of the phone case is a stapler with the option to staple documents with a metal staple that the consumer would need to refill the staples, or it can be switched to the second option of stapling paper documents without staples by punching a slight hole to insert the punch-out tab under a few bottom sheets to keep the papers together. And to summarize our company, our motto is bringing convenience wherever you go. Now we are going to address our cultural policies, which we define humane, compassionate, respect, integrity, sustainability, and adaptability. How do we want to be thought of? For Elephant Squad, we would like to create a reputation based on our environmental efforts, such as using recycled materials and having a biodegradable product, quality customer service, and treatment of employees. For example, offering health benefits for full-time employees and medical discounts for part-time employees, and for maternal and paternal leave for those who are expecting a child, whether it is by birth or adoption. And our core values we established were as how we stand as a company, as we prioritize having respect for environment, care about consumer needs so they know that they have a voice that we are attentively listening to, and making a standard for other companies to be just as compassionate about the society we contribute to. What do we love? We love making people's lives easier, since there are already enough stress from daily activities and responsibilities. What do we fear? We fear that by not offering a quality product to give even the slightest relief, we are not fulfilling our purpose on bringing innovation and convenience. There is a chance to make people's lives easier, and we aim to simply acknowledge and provide a solution. Now, for our code of ethics, it revolves on how we conduct our employees with consumers, their relationship with suppliers, and also with each other within the workplace. A few of our main code of ethics is that all employees ought to be respectful and sensitive to others' cultural backgrounds and personal values. Another is to comply with laws and maintaining fairness by not favoring one customer over another. Also, it is illegal to share company information and customer information. Another is to beware of issues regarding conflict of interest. Do not accept any form of gifts from vendors when you are at work. If you feel unsure, contact a manager for help. Be responsible on the job and maintain relationships with vendors in a professional manner. A very important one that we do recognize is that in case of a dangerous robbery, be compliant to the robber as your life comes first. It is not worth the risk to save company items or personal belongings. During situations as this, attempt to remember details of the assailant to report to police. And another important one is do not bring company merchandise or equipment home. For a company item to be borrowed, it must be approved by the manager. For our ethics board, we have Bill Gates, who is the principal founder of Microsoft Corporation. He and his wife are chairs of the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, the world's largest private charitable foundation. Elfin Squad included Bill Gates on our board because we are positive that he could provide leadership and expert advisement on our policies and development, ensuring our company's success. Next, we have Susan Dan Wojcicki, who is the CEO of YouTube. She was involved in founding Google and proposed the acquisition of YouTube. She is a self-made woman, which is why we highly welcome her onto our ethics board. We believe she will add on to our gender diversity and equality. With her guidance on moral and ethical issues, we gain valuable insights and attain success in that aspect. Lastly, for our ethics board, we have Timothy Cook, who is the CEO of Apple Incorporation. He has spent 12 years with IBM and now runs one of the most profitable businesses in America. We believe Tim Cook is a great addition to our board. He has learned from the best, his predecessor Steve Jobs, and we aim that he provides help with any potential ethical concerns. Now next, we are going to talk about experimentation for our objectives. For objective one, it was to increase profitability by 2.5% every quarter. We will experiment this by producing a set amount of inventory and record number of sales for 2 months. We will then compare the number of sales in month one and month two to see if there was an increase in sales. For objective two, it was to create a high-performing team by quarter four for year two. For our experiments, during the interview process, we will give each applicant a problem in the company that has already been solved to test on how they would handle the situation. For objective three, it was to increase the efficiency of multiple processes. And we will experiment this by training employees on how to use the new machinery and apply new methods. Then we will record their performance for 3 months, comparing each month to the next to see improvement. For the fourth objective, it was to upgrade the product and develop it to compete with competitors' products. For this experiment, we will produce a quarter's worth of inventory and then record number of sales and compare to our competitors to see if our product is meeting or exceeding the competition. And lastly, for objective five, it was to improve customer service and support experience by end of year five. The experiment for objective five, we will record dialogues of customer complaints and feedback score for 2 months, then compare the data from month one and month two to see if changes need to be made. Now we will discuss about the prototype. The Elfin Squad will create prototypes by creating a hard resin formula for the base of the phone case and molds of various mobile devices. A silicone formula will be used for the grip around the phone case and coverings for each detachable component as a texture factor. Each feature on the phone case, other than the solar panel and charging port, can detach and reattach in a similar manner to Lego building blocks, but will be secured once snapped in place. To detach a component, the user would need to press a release button that is safely covered to avoid accidental pressing. The function to detach components allows consumers to customize which component they prefer to include on the multifunctional phone case. Also, each component would have a separate mold, as our company can focus on changing a part than, you know, a whole if needed in the future. However, the electrical part of attaching the solar panel would need to be done by hand if the company is unable to secure a small-scale manufacturing machine designed for producing that particular prototype. If just the case and the solar panel and charging port permanently attach, the molds can be produced by 3D printing, where the company is able to switch out blueprints for various mobile devices that come in different shapes and sizes. To continue on with our experimentation, what tools can you use to create your experiments? Well, we have, you know, Excel sheet programs to document data. We will have a person in charge recording the data in real time, a device to track time as well, and a program to send alerts of experiment checkpoints and deadlines, and lastly, a program to track the number of sales of the product. How can you involve potential customers in the experiments? Elephant Squad can involve these customers in experiments that require collecting data of number of sales for us to measure growth and compare the sales of our competitors' products. During the time of experimentation, we will also be open for consumer feedback about the product and the quality of our customer service. And then we have two hypotheses that we would like to be tested right away. One of them is regarding the product by surveying consumers and recording their response to the product to observe if our multifunctional phone case creates convenience and have them feel more equipped for the day. With any negative feedback or changes consumer would like to see, we will adapt accordingly and alter the product design. After implementing these changes, we would conduct a second testing to observe if the changes bring more positive feedback and responses. Another hypothesis that we will test is in regards to the market. When to carry out these trials on whether student or military discounts will increase sales and bring a steady amount of new customers. This is done by documenting consumer demographics and response to the discounts, then comparing the data for a growth of sales and customers. If the discounts make less than 20% difference compared to regular sales, then we will not implement discounts but save a portion of revenue to donate to nonprofit organizations and low-income communities. Now this concludes our presentation. Thank you for listening to the Elephant Squad.